The moment you accept Christ as your Lord and Savior, you have become the citizen of the Kingdom of Heaven. Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. I'm hoping and praying you're keeping well. If you're new here, thank you so much for watching this video, and please do not forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to this channel if you are one of those who loves hearing the word of God. In today's video, I am going to share with you on how to live a life that is pleasing to God. These will be some of the things you have to do or you need to do so as you are always rooted in Christ. No matter what problems or situations comes in your life, if you are holding on to God and His promises and doing the right thing, then you don't have to worry about anything else. In the book of Hebrews chapter 13 verse 5 says that He will never leave us nor forsake us. So without any further ado, let's get into these points. After redemption and salvation, God desires you to live a holy life as His child. You must be saved in order to become a Christian. But in order to become a righteous and mature Christian, you must grow daily through the Word of God. Because faith comes, and it comes by hearing the Word of God. So number one, read the Holy Bible daily. Now I get it, everybody is busy, everybody have their own different schedules and work, but here's the deal, if you put God first, your whole day is gonna go fantastic. Now reading the Bible daily will bring you closer to God, and you will also learn every single day, how does God work, what has He done, who He is, what has He done, what is He still doing, and what He accepts us as His children to do. Book of Acts chapter 17 verse 11 says, "Now the Berean Jews were of more noble character than those in Thessalonica, for they received the message with great eagerness and examined the scriptures every day to see if what Paul said was true." Jews were more noble character than those of Thessalonica, for they received the message from Paul, the great news, but they still didn't trust Paul that much, but they went and searched and read the words by themselves. And even if you're watching my videos or somebody else's videos, that's totally fine. But hey, you have to spend the time with God all alone by yourself. Have relationship with God, a secret place, a secret relationship, because God speaks to everyone in different way. So having a relationship with Christ and spending time reading His word every single day for 1 hour, 2 hours, or even more is the best thing to do. Number two, pray daily. The book of Philippians chapter 4 verse 6 says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God." There are times we are so anxious because a family member is sick, or we're having problems at work, or we have financial issues. Problems are always going to be there in this world. But where is your focus? Prayer helps you to be in alignment with God. And you can also do one thing while you're on your way to your work and you're in the car. Well, you can listen to the podcast. You can listen to Caleb. In Florida, we have Caleb. You can listen to worship music. It's amazing. That is also a way of praying. But I highly recommend you to find that specific quiet time in the secret place with our Savior and, of course, with the Word of God. Number three, always love your God with all of your heart, mind, and soul. Book of Matthew chapter 22 verse 37 says, "Jesus replied, 'Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all of your mind.'" So as you know, the very two main commandments we have is love your God with all of your heart, mind, and soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. Now I've heard a lot of people say that love people, that's very important, love people, and yes, it's amazing, but don't forget the first commandment. And if you really, really love God, you should keep His commandments. Because the Word of God says, "If you love me, you keep my commandments." So loving people is not bad, because that's the command of God. But the very first command is putting God first and following His commandments. Amen. Number four is attend worship service regularly. Now this could be the Sunday church worship fellowship, or you can do online Bible studies. You need your fellow partners to pray with. They can pray with you, for you, and they can also study the Word of God with you. If there are any questions or anything, you can help each other, and that's how you also grow. So fellowship with the fellow believers is very important, and personally in my life, That has also helped me a lot to answer the questions sometimes which I did not understand through other brothers and sisters in Christ. Having fellowship with those people who can bring you up in faith and closer to God is way more important than having those friends who will drag you to different paths of parties, alcohol, drugs, etc. Now, I'm not judging you, but the Word of God says, bad company corrupts good morals. So be very careful whom you spend your time with. Having right people in your life at the right time and doing right things with them will help you spiritually to grow and have faith in Christ even more every single day. The book of Acts chapter 2 verse 42 says, they devoted themselves to apostles' teaching and to fellowship, the breaking of bread and to pray. That's what all the apostles did. They broke the bread together and they prayed together with fellowship. And having that kind of fellowship with our brothers and sisters in Christ is gonna help you a lot in your journey of faith. Live a life strengthened in faith and overflowing with thankfulness. The book of Colossians chapter 2 verse 7 says, rooted and built up in Him, strengthened in the faith as you were taught, and overflowing with thankfulness. Our faith is very important, and the Word of God also says that it is impossible to please God without faith. So we have to live a life where our faith is strengthened with joyfulness, peacefulness, and thankfulness. More importantly, be thankful for every single thing, every single day that God has given to you. And the last one, live as a witness for Christ, as a saved child of God, full of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The book of Acts chapter 1 verse 8 says, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. Amen. Having the Holy Spirit is the best thing ever. It's a gift from God. And when you are living your life depending on the Word of God and having faith in God, in Christ, then nobody can separate you from His love. And we are supposed to be the witnesses for Christ. We are the sons and daughters of Christ, and we are proud of that. We boast in Christ alone, not in our works, or not in other things or other people, but in Christ alone. I am not ashamed of the gospel, and I hope you are not too. Now, if you're wondering what is the meaning of gospel, I recently just uploaded that video and I will link it somewhere up here so you can go ahead and check that. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to comment down below and I will be more than happy to help you. Overall, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you learned a lot from today's video. Take care, God bless you all, and stay rooted in Christ. Bye.